What's up, guys, and welcome back. Today I wanted to take a look at something, and I wanted to maybe this can help you guys out as far as when it comes to learning a language. I started looking at language learning a little differently because about a year or so ago, I really got into Rubik's Cubes, okay? I've always been a huge fan of puzzles, but I've never known how to solve these, and I finally taught myself how to solve these. So I want to take a second to point out, kind of relate language learning to solving a Rubik's Cube, okay? This is going to represent your language that you're trying to learn. Now, this is just a 3x3, and if you're learning Korean or Japanese, you may have to use the 7x7 or something bigger because of the complexities of it, but let's just take this for example. So here's where you want to get. You want to be at the solved state of language learning. But when you start, right, it's just you've got stuff jumbled up here, jumbled up there. You don't really know where you're at, what you're doing, correct? I mean, you're always, anytime you start a language, this is kind of where you're at. You've got all these pieces and you have no idea where they go. So what you're going to do is you're looking to just solve the base first, correct? You're looking around and you're saying, okay, well, what makes up the base foundation that I'm looking for, right? So you start looking around, you start seeing stuff. The base is going to be made up of your general useful phrases, your hellos, your goodbyes, things like that. That's basically what you're looking to go into your base. So you solve it for a while, you start adding phrases until, flip that around here, you're starting to see it's starting to look more, you're starting to get a little more stuff lined up there. Until just like that, your base is solved. You now know your useful phrases and stuff like that. Next, you're gonna want to build on top of this. You're not looking to go anywhere else. You're just wanting to build on top of that base. So you start thinking, well, what can I do? So your next level that you're gonna be building here is actually maybe your core list of frequency words that you can use in order to maintain a conversation. You start adding stuff here and there. Oh, piece that together there. Maybe a little bit more until before too long, and you've got a really, really solid base going on there. You've got your useful phrases and stuff down here, and up on that, you've built a higher frequency word list that you can use to communicate your general ideas. Now, the top is going to be broken into two parts, and that's because there's a couple of other things you need to do. Now, people may disagree with the way that I'm doing this, but the top layer, the next most important thing, is listening. Now, I would normally say listening is down here because listening is very, very important, but most people tend to use Duolingo or memorize or something of that nature, and so they generally do the listening a little bit later, which is really going to help enforce what's below. And that's why I put listening up here, because it's on top and it enforces everything below, right? So you're looking to solve this top side for listening because you want to be able to understand what people are saying to you when they speak. So, and just like that, you've got your base and you can start to understand stuff, you can speak to them, and then you've got your listening down. Now, the next part is simple to realize what we're talking about. The next part is grammar, and this is last, okay? A lot of people will study grammar up front. I've done that myself in the past, but I'm actually, the more that I get into it, the more that I honestly think grammar should be held here, because grammar is a deterrent, okay? Like for me, Spanish, I struggle with verbs, but what I started doing is not worrying about it. If I need to say something is in the past, I will say, you know, cocinar pasado, right? Because it's going to get the idea across, and then I can work on getting my verbs to where they need to be. This is where grammar comes in, okay? So you're going to start adding some grammar in order to be able to make all this coherent, okay? So you're going to do that, and it's almost there. I mean, like, if you were to look at this, you can obviously tell, like, this would be enough to get you by, but you're still not at that perfect state yet. So you're gonna keep on adding, and this kind of goes just with grammar in general. This takes a little bit longer to solve, and it's just like grammar. It takes longer to learn, right? So now you're even closer, right? This is matched up. You only got a couple of pieces. They're out of place, and all you got to do, get those last couple of pieces in place, and you're now speaking the language. I hope that made sense to you. It makes sense in my head. I'm sure watching this back, I may think that I needed to do something a little differently, but that's how I relate to language learning. I'm a huge puzzle fan, and languages are just spoken puzzles. You've got to figure out which piece goes where in order to make the puzzle work. And that's just my thoughts on the matter. So I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Thank you so much for watching. Give it a share if you liked it. Maybe somebody else can relate to this. Subscribe to my channel. I'll do new videos every single week. Thank you for watching, and I will see you guys in the next video.